Yeah. Well, it is all your fault.
It is all my fault.
I guess you could start with that. Explain how all
the whole war
in the Middle East.
Yeah, no, I
tell them.
I went and I looked up, like, I saw the wall. I was like, man, that's fucked up. And I posted on Twitter, I mean X. And then a day later, Palestinians, well, not Palestinians, Hamas decided, hey, you know what? That guy was right. This is fucked up. And did another fucked up thing and massacred a bunch of civilians. So it's pretty much my fault. Yeah.
Boom. All because of a post. So good job. Yeah. I had nothing to do with it. I told him, hey, I don't think you should do this. I think this could start a catastrophe.
And I said, hey, what did one post do?
Yeah, something. What are they arguing about? What are they arguing about? Hummus? What is that, chickpeas or something? Well, yeah, it goes back to the Bible. Ishmael had a bunch of hair on his arms, and the father was going blind. So when he talked to him, he'd feel his arms to know it was him because he had real hairy arms. So the mother disguised Isaac as the other brother by putting goat fur on his arms. And the father felt him. It was like, oh, you're my Ishmael, and blessed him with the land. Supposedly, that's where I think this all started. I have no fucking idea. Dude, I couldn't even give a shit. I've tried to care. Like, I'll just be honest. As a dude that's been hearing about the Middle East his whole life, I don't give a fuck anymore. Like Israel, because they're like our only homies, supposedly. You said the black metal thing and something important happened. Pretty cool attack. When I first saw that, it was like, what is this, a fucking joke? Like, I thought it was like a joke. And then they show the videos, like, they're just like dancing at that festival and they just show them in the background. It's like, are you fucking kidding me? They just like, that's like how fucking Red Dawn started. I don't know. You've just never seen paragliders and think back.
Yeah,
it's like if they attacked in hot air balloon. Have you heard the joke about Louis C.K. where he talks about Jews? But it's like, it's the only thing. You just put a little stank on it and it sounds so bad. Even though that's what you're supposed to call them is Jews. Mm. But you just put a little stank on Jews. Oh, sorry. I was going to say, I've never met any Jews, so I started doing stand-up. There's a bunch of Jewish people in stand-up. I know they always like make jokes about that, but there really is. So really, all the Jews I've become friends with just through stand-up. Well, both the Jewish guys I'm friends with, they're comics, and they take it pretty serious. One has taken it more serious as he got older. His father passed. He kind of took it more serious. And the other one always took it serious. He walks around. He's got a yarmulke he always wears. So, like, you always know he's, like, down.
Yeah.
And it was funny because he was a comic out here, and he was a vegetarian. And I was like, man, how long have you been a vegetarian? He's like, well, I'm not actually a vegetarian. I was like, you don't eat meat. He's like, I only don't eat meat because we don't have a rabbi out here to bless it. He was like, if I could get kosher meat, I'd eat it. But because I can't out here on the island, I got to be a vegetarian. Right. I was thinking about this. All right. You know, they can't be around pork. Okay. And they always say how, like, Jewish people, like, control banks. But then they have piggy banks. I looked it up. They used to only be allowed to practice finance in the Middle Ages. It's one of the only jobs they could have.
Yeah, because Christians weren't allowed to lend money.
Hey, I don't think the Holocaust was cool.
All right.
On the record.
On the record.
Not cool, guys.
Holocaust, not cool.
That's my official stance on that. It really is. I rarely take sides, but I don't think that was very cool, though.
One being Madagascar. Another being, I think, Sri Lanka. Specific sect of Jews called Zionists who believe that...
Are those called... Yeah, there you go, Zion.
Yeah.
Zion. Put that on the record, too. The British fucked this up, not America. Jesus Christ. We didn't make Israel. Y'all can yell at fucking England for that shit.
Well, it was a three-way... it's basically a three-way birthing. between UK, the USSR, and the United States.
So it's only a third of our fault, y'all.
Yeah.
That's 33.3. I was looking it up. Like, even in Roman times, you couldn't just roll up into a city. They would be like, "Where? What the fuck?" You'd have to like get permission, and then they would be like, search you, and then make you like walk through the city.
After that was like a huge displacement of Palestinian people from the land called the Nakba.
Man, you're going down. There's so many wars over
Oh, there's so many wars, and it's just a fucking rabbit hole of wars and retaliations and hatred. And oh man, another piece of propaganda that's been really, really annoying me is Israel calling this an unprovoked attack when they've been fighting each other since the fucking beginning.
It's the blood and crypts of the Middle East.
Only I could clone me. Government can't fucking clone me.
I already have samples of your DNA frozen, so I have DNA of all my friends
It
and some cool dogs I've met.
to some fucking music. This is from a band you might
Ooh.
know with their song War. And if you know the band, well, you know the band. Hit it.
Judgment and deliverance. Go up a soul, this monkey's soul. A dead time or a priest. A victory number, this hell jumps. What the hell did I was like? Teaches us so. Reason he must obtain must be helped by his God, his child.
But this is blood of war.
Of war, we don't speak anymore of war. We don't speak anymore of war. We don't speak anymore of war. We're all we got to war.
Man, I used to listen to the ever living shit out of this album.
It's a fucking great
This is
album.
probably the first CD I listened to. I like memorize this album.
That
Yeah.
was
That's a great fucking band.
System of a Down with War off their album.
That was the first one with a hand.
Yeah, System of a Down. All right.
It self-titled?
Yep.
Yeah, self-titled.
Oh, my fucking.
That was one of the first albums I really fell in love too. Back in the day when you had to go to Best Buy and you didn't have a whole lot of options.
There was a Lonely Days. I hated that song because I think people like really latched on to that. And I was like, this fucking song sucks. Why do you keep fucking playing it? They have so many better fucking songs. And a good commentary on war and how you got to demonize people to fight and kill them. And oh boy, have both sides demonized each other. Stop killing.
I mean, America, we put up with Canada. Do you know how hard it is for us to get along with Canada? Those pieces of shit. And we find it somehow to get along with them.
I am the Middle East. I'm shooting myself.
Boom.
Theory versus practice.
Everyone I've talked to, I think the wall's kind of fucked up.
Yeah.
I don't care how you like split it up. I don't think you could just have a wall around a minority race. Like, even in the South, we never did that shit. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know how the fuck you can have a city of just a wall built around people and then be like, yeah, you can't come and go as you please. Yeah, we might shut off your power and you don't get as much water. And then when those people get pissed off and kidnap some people, I don't know how you can be like,
totally unprovoked. Why would they ever do that?
Everyone I've talked to has this opinion. Everyone I've talked to, but they're afraid to say it out loud because we like Jewish people. We're friends with them. We don't want to offend them. But, like, you know, I grew up with a Middle Eastern kid I was really tight with. And, like, his dad was they were from Iraq or wherever Saddam Hussein's from. Which one's that? Iraq, right?
That's Iraq.
And he told me something. He told me something fucked up that you have to have a psycho like Saddam Hussein rule a country there. And this is what he told us. He was like, they don't respect like a guy like Obama or Trump. They're like, they look at a guy like that and it's like, he can't even like kill a bear with his bare hands. You know what I'm saying? He's a wimp. He doesn't know how to like ride a horse, a camel. You know what I'm saying? They consider a guy like that a wimp. And like, they only respect guys that just will kill you. That's what they think a man is. This is the words of the uncle telling us kids this. Something else, like we had this civil war in America, right? Had a good war, killed each other, had a blast. Then they kind of buried the hatchet, it seems like. Or at least somewhat buried the hatchet. Let's go back to being a country. Yeah, it's like, all right, Middle East, like, can you just at least get this war over? Like, good Lord, how long is it going to stretch out for? Like, get it over with and shake hands. Like, but I mean, I don't know how they could just have this wall. I mean, everyone's looked at that wall for a while and been like,
something's going to pop out of there and kill a bunch of things.
We're like, I think it's weird they got a wall around them. Like, well, you stole land from Indians.
It's like, yeah, that's fucked up too.
What does that got to do with this? Like,
can't you condemn both? Indians were considered basically terrorists. They would raid fucking settler camps and try to, you know, get off our land, stop killing our food. It's whataboutism. It's like, you were allowed to commit genocide. Why can't we?
Yeah, it's like if we go back in time, I wouldn't do that. Or,
like, or I'd say something about it at the very least.
But like Davy Crockett in Tennessee was very against moving the Native Americans. Like he fought tooth and nail before the Trail of Tears. And he lost. And was like, fuck this, I'm going to Texas.
After this attack, Israel responded with a very heavy hand, basically just bombing the shit out of Gaza. And for reference, do you want to know how big Gaza is for reference?
I believe it's what? It's miles by miles.
It's three-fourths the size of Molokai.
Well, and then there's that chunk of the West Bank. And yeah. I don't think they're just going to be like, and we're cool with this side now.
No. In fact, since the attacks, there's been lots of like vigilante attacks on Palestinians by settlers. And the police are just kind of allowing it to happen. And so it started creating like little rebel factions in the West Bank, which are going to be called terrorists, and probably excuse for more IDF involvement there.
It is clear shit that Biden has lost mental, he's out of it. He's clearly an old man that has lost his mental, his cognitive, whatever the fuck.
Well, at least
And
when it comes to
they're
Israel,
hiding it.
like every but no one needs to actually use their brain when it comes to Israel. They're like, Israel's
It's just
good.
gotta.
Back Israel. The media, all the fucking leaders, Biden, Trump, fucking all the Republican nominees, back Israel. 100%. You don't need to think about it, whoever's in charge.
This is it. Every Christian in the South is taught that those are God's chosen people and they are better than you. As a kid, I was told Jews are better than you. And I'm like, why? And they're like, because they're God's chosen people. Because God said so. And I was like, why? He's like, that's just how the fuck it is and accept it. And they believe that. Any nation that protects, there's a verse that says, any nation that protects my people will prosper. And a lot of Christians have took that verse to heart. Jesus was a Jew. That's what they say. They go, Jesus was a Jew. And they go, and it goes in the Bible, they killed him. They go, that doesn't fucking matter. That's because God wanted him to die. That was all part of God's plan. That's not for you. Don't even worry about that shit, dumb fuck. Don't worry yourself. That literally, they're like, don't question it. It's not even your job to question it, dude. Just there was a reason. They believe that the Jews killed Jesus because they wanted the second coming of Christ to actually happen. They're like, dude, the Jews were trying to help. When the Jews rebuild their temple, there's a couple things that have to line up for Jesus to come back, and one of them is. Yes, the Jews will rebuild the King Solomon's temple. I got a friend I grew up with that told me he only votes for president according to who's going to help out Israel the most.
I guess we should play another song. This is from a local band from Maui.
Yeah.
From Order of the White Rose, with a song called Who Would Jesus Bomb?
I'm
Dude, these guys rock. Dude, I'd love to see these guys. Oh, my God.
That was Order of the White Rose with Who Would Jesus Bomb off the album War Machine.
That song kicked fucking ass. That was a fucking banger, dude. If you don't like that song out there, weak ass.
Something wrong with you.
Something wrong with you, man. You got rocks in your head.
So Israel has recently done a ground invasion and has encircled Gaza City. And
bro, they are exiting them. It is that is going to be part of Israel now.
Basically, yeah, they've evacuated all those willing to evacuate. Today, I think they've got to the main, like, one of the biggest hospitals in Gaza, which they said was being used as a Hamas hub.
Of course they did. I know people are, like, yelling at, like, Hamas and shit, but it's like, I mean, that's almost, I mean, it is like the IRA that freed Ireland. Like, the IRA had to fight too. Like,
yeah, no, this is a hard one because it's a tactic. All asymmetric warfare, you need to be able to retreat. If you're fighting someone much larger than you, you need to be able to retreat. In Cuba, you can retreat to the mountains. In Vietnam, you can retreat in the jungle. In Gaza, there's not much you can retreat to besides the buildings and more people.
And tunnels.
Yeah, and so I remember reading like their strategy. They say, well, our forest, our people are our forest. And it sounds really poetic until you realize he's saying, no, we're just going to hide among the civilians. And if our enemy's willing to basically slaughter the civilians and look like complete monsters, which they are for doing, then so be it. And that's a monstrous tactic. Thing about civilians also on the Israeli side is, you know, every civilian is supposed to take like 2 years of military service. When you're an adult, you're supposed to take military service. And so every civilian is supposed to be a military asset.
They tell you about my buddy. Well, there was a band called Black Lips that was really big for like a summer or two in like, I don't know, 2008. Yeah, but I knew this guy. You guys can see it on Vice. There's an early episode when Black Lips goes to Israel. And one of their connection there, the guy that set up the tour was an Israeli guy named Noam. And he used to be in a metal band. I can't remember the name of it. It was something donkey something. But he ended up moving to America, and I got to know this guy, Noam, and they tried to get him in the fucking army. And he said, they're like, you got to do this fucking army shit. And he refused. And he said they put him in jail.
Yeah.
And he said he was in jail for a while. And he said, like, in the mornings, they'd make him get handcuffed and shit, and they'd march him through the chow. Of the military, where the military soldiers were eating, having like breakfast, they'd make this prisoners walk through on handcuffs, and they would be like, see this? This is what fucking happens to you if you don't join the army. This is what's going to fucking happen to you. And then he was in there for, I think he did 10 months. And then one of the guys in there was like, you want to get out of jail? And he was like, yeah. He's like, tell them you're gay. And he was like, what? He's like, yeah. Just go to the office and tell them you're gay. And so he went to like the warden or whatever. He's like, I gotta tell you something. He's like, well, he's like, yeah, I'm gay. And he said, the warden's like, oh, like gross. Like, get the fuck out of here. We don't want you in the army. And he got out of jail because of that. No shit. He didn't have to go in the army. I'm not even kidding you. So he told me. There's like, well, oh,
nobody talks about the Israeli army to gay pipeline.
I guess the loop. Yeah, fucking
Israel making gays all day. Should we play another song?
Yeah, so no. Yeah.
Yeah, here's another Maui Rocket band. Shit. band is called Pilau, but not like Kevin Titt's band Pilau, but Pilau with all the letters like period at the end of them. So it's an acronym of some sort.
All right.
It's a metal band. Stink. This is Time for War by Pilau off the album, off their demo. We'll be right back. right, that was Pilau with Time for War. At least it was for you out in the interwebs. For us, we had technical difficulties.
Yeah, I'll have to listen to it later.
Few technical difficulties, local band, shit deals, sorry.
You just fake it. Oh my god, that song rules.
Fuck yeah, it does.
Dude, I love the harpsichord. That was the greatest 28-minute harpsichord solo I've ever heard.
So because of that, here, we'll play.
I'm not going to lie to you, folks. I'm going to keep it straight.
Here's another Hawaii band. Hopefully this goes through. This was Sod with Beyond War. That was Beyond War by Sod off the album Sod is Dead, released in 1986.
It was a bitchin' song.
Yeah, especially
yeah, for it was a bitchin' motherfucking song.
Especially for Hawaii in 1986.
Yeah, it's pretty insane.
Speaking of Sod, I guess we should talk about the wider region. Because it said that this attack was supposed to, like, stop the normalization of Israel with Saudi Arabia and put pressure on its allies and something to do with Iran. I don't know.
Oh, no.
I know. Okay. Iran funds and backs Hamas. Also, Hezbollah, which is in Lebanon, which is an anti-Israel militia group, is like more powerful than some states in the region. As there are a bunch of Iranian-backed cells in Syria and Iraq who have recently been attacking U.S. bases. With suicide drones and artillery. And the U.S. has been striking back with drone bombs and shit like that.
So, if you want to enlist, kids, got another war for you.
Yeah, it's coming. Now's the time. If you're tired of your grandpa saying, back in my day, we had a war to fight. Fuck you, grandpa, and join the next one.
Yep. You get bragging rights your whole life. You can always rub it in other people's faces that you're a little more American than everyone else because you're in the military. You know, I serve. Yes, we know. Yeah, you get two choices when you graduate from a public school in America. Prison, military.
You could be like me and be homeless.
The America's going to get a pound of flesh from your ass. Either military, prison, credit card debt, student debt, or just a thankless job that breaks your back. But no matter what, this country's rigged to get a pound of flesh from your ass. And they're going to get it.
Seriously, from Yemen? What?
If I was looking at a map without anything on it, I don't know if I could.
Can you point out Egypt?
Ball pick in the Red Sea and the Black Sea. And you're like,
could you pick out Egypt?
Yeah, I could do that. Oh, yeah, it's right above that shit, right?
Yes.
What's so? The fucking Islam came. They're like came out of the same religion.
Yeah, the Abraham.
Like literally. Yeah, it's like it's so funny. Abraham in it. Like. Yeah.
And honestly, I hate the Abraham story.
Abraham. Why don't you tell me the story?
All I know about him is him trying to kill his son. God going, nope, that was a trick. Mostly because I've read Kierkegaard over and over and over again.
The hell is that?
That is a Christian philosopher. Existentialist philosopher who is like, well, yeah, religion doesn't make sense, so fucking what? That's the point. Follow Jesus.
I wouldn't mind a score at the end, or like at least a highlight reel,
a like, grade
of the cool shit. You like winning a fist fight in elementary school, and you're like, hell yeah. Like that was pretty awesome.
When you die, you see a bright white light, and then it gives you a school grade. Yeah, D-.
Yeah. Failed.
But I thought I did pretty good. You didn't even fucking answer the questions.
That literally, if I died, you're like, what did you do with your life? I'm like, well, I beat Grand Theft Auto twice. Three, so that's something.
So what'd you do, Grandpa?
I know, and they'd be like, did you get all the hidden packages? And they'd be like, no. But, so you really didn't even get 100% completion. You just finished story mode. Ass. Well, you never saw Jungle Book?
I saw Jungle Book. I just didn't, like, I don't know. I didn't, like.
What the hell did you think that was about?
Some kid in the jungle.
God damn it, shits. What? Well, you grew up in a jungle, so you're probably like, oh, hey, it's like Puna. They just...
Yeah, except they have tigers. Were there any Jews in Disney films?
Hell no. No. I don't fucking know. I don't think they're ever just like, well, let's put a Jew in. I'm sure there is. Like, no, wait, Walt Disney hated Jews.
Did he?
Yeah, that's like historically, he was an anti-Semite.
Russian talking to an American, and America goes, we have so much more freedom in America than you have over there in Russia. We could go up to the White House and go, fuck you, fuck America, and we'll be fine. And the Russian goes, we have the same freedom. I could go up to the White House and say, fuck you, fuck America too.
Wow, play a song. Are you going to play a song?
Yeah, let's play World War III. I have two songs here.
You're getting distracted here.
Yeah.
Rambling. We got a song, motherfuckers.
Two songs.
It's about how you're all going to die one day.
Two songs.
Three songs? Two songs.
One called World War III by a Filipino band called Repugnant. And the... next one called World War III by Moon Bandits. Yeah.
That was a good song.
That was World War III by the Moon Bandits off the album Property Damage, A Love Story.
Bing bang or anything.
And I guess that's all I have to say is I don't like it. I mean, what I have to say about the...
you like the song.
I like the song.
Yeah.
I don't like the conflict in the war.
Yeah, I mean, maybe not building a wall around people and telling them they can't come and go free. Maybe an open air prison.
Yeah, maybe that's not a good idea.
Cool. Like, everyone's like, so you don't believe in Israel? It's like, what the fuck? I didn't say that. I'm just saying.
You know, if
maybe the, just
if Israel let them like be free. And their borders, and like any other citizen.
Dude, I think they're straight up just going to kick him out. Afraid it's going to happen. They kick him out. Boom. That's Israel now. And I don't know. I don't know if they'll use the inertia to kick out the West Bank or maybe wait for a couple years. I'm like, holy shit, I can't believe we pulled that off.
Egypt's not letting them in. And besides that, where are they going?
I was wondering about that. It's like, they're not even going to let them go to the West Bank. Like, no. Are you going to let them go to the other Palestine? And they're like, no. It's like, oh, okay. Like, you can't even let them go to the other Palestine? Like, because they're like, we cut it in half. So, like, oh, so there's two of them. Like, yeah. It's like, can they go to the other one? They're like, no. It's like, yeah, that seems kind of weird. Like, you can't just escort them to the other Palestine where they're allowed to be. They're like, no. All right. That seems kind of crazy. But America's like, well, we got our homie in Israel. So, like, that's our homie. Like, we got to have someone over there, like, that's got our back. So, just, like, politically, America's going to side with them. Because it's like, dude, that's our – we know they got our back there. Because we give them, like, everything.
Yeah. Like, all of the fucking missiles shot in the Gaza probably came from the United States.
Yeah, like Lockheed Martin. And America hasn't interceded yet. And they're like, yeah, okay, we're going in to kick them out. And they're like, okay, continue. They're just going to, like, scratch that little part off of the map. Just Israel.
And we're just going to watch because we can't do anything. Well, on that depressing note, let's end this. I got one last song and we'll end it.
Yeah, like I feel for all these people dying, man. Both sides. Like, I don't know. They just smoke pot. The religious, hardcore religious people just kind of suck. I don't care if you're a Baptist or a fucking Hindu or whatever the fuck, dude. But anytime you're a hardcore religious person, usually you suck ass, man.
This last song's called Lost War Song by a
And it
band
is by
called
NSYNC.
Akasilka.
Akasilka. That's a fun. I like that.
From Okinawa.
Nice.
And we'll end
Okinawa.
it on that.
Shoots.
Lost War Song by Akasilka from Okinawa.
It was loud.
As one of my favorite bands, honestly. I love it. It's so wild.
It's like a gypsies. A
yeah.
caravan of screaming Japanese people.
I should learn Japanese to scream it. That'd be great. Need a Japanese song now.
Yeah. Yeah, we got a project.
Anyway, that'll be it for tonight. Thanks for joining me, having to cover this topic so I could get it out the way.
Well, you know, the people want to know what we think about this.
Yeah.
They've been asking us nonstop.
I know. And I mean, so many emails telling me, like, what's your position? And I just keep going, can I not touch it?
Well, can I have a minute to get my statement together, my official statement?
I know it's been a month and a half, but...
Has it been going on that long?
At least a month now.
Dude, they're just literally going to just... They're cleaning them out. Like, I'm trying to use a word beside genocide. I'm trying so hard to not say that word. But I don't know what the fuck else to call it. When you're just like, okay, get your shit and get the fuck out or I'm going to kill you.
Yeah, there's been a lot of things that have been called a genocide by one group of people. But this is so obviously, like, if anything's genocide, what that is going on right now is genocide.
Yeah. I mean, if you just... I mean, it's so hard not to be like... like, literally what the Nazis did to them. They're like, all right, we're moving you into a ghetto. And then literally, I mean, besides, they're not gassing them, but they are like throwing bombs at them and like, move, move. If you get in the way of our bombs, you're going to die. Yeah, dude, it's fucked, dude. I don't know what the fuck, but what are they doing with them? They're just pushing them out. Like in Israel, Egypt won't let them in. So they're just like, where are they?
I don't know. They told them all to evacuate south, but the south doesn't have any infrastructure for them. And again, they're being cut off by food and water because they're fenced in.
Just force them onto some like little FEMA camp or something.
Oh, it's worse than a FEMA camp. Even a FEMA camp has water.
Yeah, it's like shelled.
Yeah.
Okay. Even a FEMA camp doesn't. No. FEMA camp's a step up. This is a new sort of hell. Post all they want on Facebook. I'm just telling you, like, America is going to be like, oh, we're just going back to those Romans.
Yeah.
Like, the government. And Biden's not going to stop. He's just like, oh, whatever. It's all good. I'm just here to.
Yeah. It's pretty much the same, like, among anybody on the American elite. Trump and Biden are basically all the same step of this. Like, so, I don't know. Anyway.
Yeah.
Good night, everybody.
Oh, yeah. Sorry, guys.
It's a bummer. But sometimes life's a bummer.
Good ending. That's the saddest shit ever.
Anyway, mahalo nui loa. Take care, everybody.
All I can say is I love both Muslims and Jews. I hope you guys figure this out, man, peacefully. So I guess that's my final thought.
Peace.
Love you guys.